तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वंशकौपतरुभ्यश्च कृपसिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितनं पवनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वासुदेव गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। So we're continuing the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as described in the Madhya Lila, and we're on chapter 14, which describes the Hara Panchami festival.
Hara Panchami.
Hara means to see, and Panchami means the fifth.
Hara 的意思呢是看 ，Panchami 的意思是第五。
Because this festival takes place 5 days after Rath Yatra.
因为这个节日呢是在弹车节的第五天，弹车节结束之后的第五天所发生的。
So Lord Chaitanya had come from Nilachal. He'd come from Sundarachala, and he came back to Nilachala.
所以说呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他就从 Sundarachala 回到了 Nilachala.
In other words, he'd come back to the main temple of Jagannath.
换句话说呢，就是主加格纳他就回到了加格纳这个庙。
So he wanted to talk to Swarup Damodar about the particular type of devotional service which was taking place here.
那他呢想要和 Swarup Damodar 来讲述在这个地方所发生的特定的奉纳服务。
So he, Lord Chaitanya asked a question to Swarup Damodar.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就向 Swarup Damodar 询问了问题。
He says, Jagannath, Lord Jagannath was enjoying his pastimes in Dwarka, and he seemed to be happy there, but still once a year he likes to go to Vrindavan.
他说呢，主加格纳在瓦尔克看起来好像还是挺享受他在那儿的这个生活，享受他在那儿的逍遥时光的。但是呢，他每年还得回文大门一次。
Excuse me, sorry. Lord Chaitanya pointed out to some gardens which were around the temple, and he said, all of these gardens here, they're just like Vrindavan.
然后主持丹尼尔马巴布他就指着在庙周围的这些花园，就说到所有的这些花园的感觉就像在文达文一样。
So Lord Jagannath was always eager to see these gardens.
所以主加格纳特呢总是非常热切的想要看这些花园们。
So Lord Jagannath gives he makes an excuse that he wants to take part in the Rath Yatra festival.
但虽然说
he makes an excuse. It's like Jekyll.
Yes, yes. 这个主加格纳呢，其实呢，他是想要找些借口，是想去参加这个弹车节。
Yeah, but actually his reason is he wants to go to the Gundicha temple.
但其实真正的原因呢，是主加格纳他想去古地下庙。
He wants to leave Jagannath Puri.He wants to leave Jagannath Puri in order to go to Gundicha, which is like Vrindavan.
He 呢其实是想离开 Jagannath Puri, 就 Jagannath 的庙，然后呢去到 Gundicha. Gundicha 就好像是 Vrindavan 一样。
So why didn't he take Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, with him?
那他为什么不带着 Lakshmi, 就是 幸运女神和他一起去呢？
So Swarup Damodar has to reply to this question.
所以说呢 ，Swarup Damodar 他就必须得回答 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所提出的这个问题。
So Swarup Damodar tells Lord Chaitanya, he said, Lakshmi Devi is the goddess of fortune, and she cannot get into the pastimes of Vrindavan.
然后呢 ，Swarup Damodar 就对主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，说 Lakshmi 呢，她就是幸运女神，所以呢，她是没有办法进入到 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光的。
And the pastimes of Vrindavan.It's only the gopis. The only people who take part in these pastimes are the gopis, and nobody else can attract the mind of Krishna but the gopis.
在 Vrindavan 呢，只有 gopi 们才能够参与到这些逍遥时光中来。在 Vrindavan， 除了 gopi 能够吸引 Sri Krishna 的心之外，其他没有任何人能够吸引得住 Krishna 的心。
So Lord Chaitanya says, Lord Jagannath.Uses the Ratiyatra as an excuse, and he brings with him Subhadra Maharani and Lord Balaram.
然后呢，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，主 Jagannath 就把弹车节这个事儿呢当成了一个借口，然后呢，他就带着Subhadra Maharani 还有主 Balaram 和他一起去的。
All the pastimes which Lord Jagannath has with the gopis take place in the gardens, and they're very confidential.And nobody knows about them.
而主 Jagannath 和 Gopi 们所上演的这些逍遥时光呢，全部都是在花园里面上演的，而且是非常的机密的，没有任何一个人可以知道这些逍遥时光。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "There's no fault in any of Krishna's pastimes. So why does the goddess of fortune become angry?"
然后主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就说。在主 Jagannath 的这个逍遥时光里边是没有任何错误的，那为什么幸运女神还会生气呢
？So Swarup Damodar said, "This is the nature of a girl who's in love."
然后 Swarup Damodar 说，在爱情中的女人就是这样的，在爱情中的姑娘就是这样的。
When the young girl finds some neglect in her lover, she'll become angry.
那么当一个年轻姑娘觉得被自己的爱人忽视了的时候呢，她就会生气。
So while Swarup Damodar and Lord Chaitanya were talking, the goddess of fortune came out of the temple.
所以呢，就当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和 Swarup Damodar 正说着的时候呢，幸运女神就从庙里出来了。
And so she was riding on a golden palanquin carried by four men.
她呢就坐在一座金轿子里，然后四个人抬着她，四个男子抬着她。
And the whole palanquin was covered with many jewels.
整个的这个庙整个这个轿子呢，就上面盖满了很多的珠宝。
And the palanquin was surrounded by people carrying umbrellas and chamaras and flags.
然后呢，这个轿子周围还围满了很多人。这些人呢，他们都扛着旗帜，扇着扇子，还有就是打着雨伞，打着阳伞。
And there were musicians and dancing girls.
还有音乐人，还有跳着舞的姑娘们。
And there were maid servants who carried a lot of water, pots of water.
还有很多的女仆，她们手里都拿着水罐。
And there were boxes for betel nuts.
她们还有很多的盒子，这盒子里面有很多的槟榔果。
And there were many, many maid servants, all dressed very beautifully and wearing valuable necklaces.
而且呢，在她周围围绕着很多很多的女仆，所有的这些女仆呢，都打扮得非常的美丽动人。他们都戴着很漂亮的项链。
So the goddess of fortune comes to the main gate of the temple in an angry mood.
所以呢，幸运女神呢就从主门出来了，非常的愤怒。
And she comes along with all of her family members.
她和她所有的家人一起出来的。
So when the procession of the maidservants and the goddess of fortune, when the procession gets to Nilachala, Well, no, when they get to Gundicha, because they go down to Gundicha, the procession goes down to Gundicha, so then all the maidservants of the goddess of fortune start to arrest the servants of Lord Jagannath.
然后呢，就当幸运女神以及她的这些女仆从女沙拉去到贡地沙的时候，当他们要到贡地沙，到了贡地沙之后呢，就是幸运女神和她的女仆们就开始抓捕 Jagannath 的仆人们。
Right, Lord Jagannath is Krishna, and Krishna hadn't come back.
但是呢，主 Jagannath 是 Krishna， 那 Krishna 这会儿还没回来呢。
So the goddess of fortune was angry.
所以幸运女神就特别的愤怒。
So her servants, they got the servants of Lord Jagannath, and they made them all bow down to the goddess of fortune.
所以说呢，幸运女神的仆人们呢，女仆们就把 Jagannath 的仆人都给抓起来了，然后并且强迫让这些仆人们。
So they made all the servants of Jagannath look just like thieves.
他们让主 Jagannath 的仆人们看着就像是贼一样。
And they were having all of the servants of the goddess of fortune were taking everything away from the servants of Jagannath.
What do you mean take everything away?
Take all their wealth, all their riches.
Okay. 然后呢，幸运女神的女仆人呢，就把 Jagannath 的仆人身上所有的这些值钱的东西全部给卸下来了。
Yeah, when Lord Jagannath had gone for the Rath Yatra, he had promised the goddess of fortune that he would return the next day.
因为当主 Jagannath 他去参加弹车节的时候呢，他和幸运女神承诺的是他第二天就回来。
But the goddess of fortune was waiting.2 days and then 3 days, and then she began to feel her husband had neglected her.
但是呢，幸运女神在家里边等她的丈夫等了两天，等了三天，然后她就觉得她被她的丈夫给忽略了。
So she became a bit angry, and she decorated herself, and she came out of the temple.
所以说呢，幸运女神就有点生气了，所以她就把自己给。装扮了起来，然后从庙里面走出来了。
And then she goes to Gundicha and she gets her men, her people to arrest all the servants of Jagannath.
所以说呢，他就来到了 Gundicha， 并且呢让他的手下的人就把主 Jagannath 的手下的人全部给抓起来了。
So when the servants of Jagannath fall down in front of the goddess of fortune, they're almost unconscious.
所以说呢，当 Jagannath 的仆人拜倒在幸运女神的面前的时候，他们就基本上就昏过去了的状态。
They were chastised and they made a lot of jokes about them and used a lot of bad language to describe them.
因为呢，就是幸运女神的仆人们就斥骂，还有讥笑、折磨。
It's all a drama. It's not actually happening. It's just a drama.
但是呢，这只不过是一场戏而已，它其实并不是真事儿。
So Lord Chaitanya and all of his men, they were watching and they were seeing how the goddess of fortune's people were treating the servants of Jagannath, and they were laughing.
那么主 Jagannath.The Lord Jagannath, they are watching, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is watching.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is watching.
Okay. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 还有就是他的同游就在看着这一场戏的上演，然后呢，看着幸运女神的这些女仆们如何斥责 Jagannath 的仆人们，所以呢，他们就使劲笑着，就特别开心看着。
And they cover their faces with their hands and smile.And Swarup Damodar says, oh, so much egoistic pride.
然后呢，斯巴那如果达摩达尔就说呢，哎呀，这简直有太大的假我的骄傲了。
I've never seen or heard of anything so much in these three worlds.
在这三界中，我从来没有看见过这般景象。
When a woman is neglected and disappointed, then her egoistic pride becomes very strong.
那么当一个女子她愤怒了，因为她被忽视了的时候，那她的这种假我所展现出来的自豪，那骄傲是如此的强悍。
Usually what happens when a woman is neglected and disappointed, she'll take off all of her ornaments.
那通常来说，当一个女孩她要是被忽略了，并且她觉得很失望的话呢，她就会把她身上所有的饰品给摘掉。
And she sits on the ground and she'll mark the lines on the ground with her nails.
然后呢，她会坐在这个地上，然后呢用她的指甲在地上画很多的标记。
So we heard of that kind of pride in Lord Krishna's wife Satyabhama.
那么我们在主 Krishna 的妻子 Satyabhama 身上，其实是听到过他展现过这样的骄傲的。
And I also we'd also heard of it in the gopis of Vrindavan.
那我们也听到Vrindavan 的 gopi 们也有过。
But here, in the case of the goddess of fortune, we see a different kind of pride.
但是呢，在这里，在幸运女神的身上呢，我们看到是另外一种骄傲。
She shows her own opulence and goes with her soldiers to attack her husband.
她呢，显示了她自己的富裕，她是带着她自己的兵士去攻打她的丈夫。
So Swarup Damodar was describing like this to Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢 ，Swarup Damodar 呢就这样向 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 描述着。
He was telling Lord Chaitanya about the gopis' loving affairs.
他在向 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 讲着 gopis 们的爱恋的故事。
But he said, "I've never seen anything like the behavior of the goddess of fortune."
但是他说呢，我从来就没有见过像幸运女神所展现出来的这种行为。
Sometimes.A proud woman, she may be frustrated due to the neglect of her husband.
那么有的时候呢，就是一位非常骄傲的女子，她可能就是由于被她的丈夫的忽视而感到非常的沮丧。
So when the husband neglects her, then she gives up caring for her appearance.
所以说呢，当她的丈夫惹她不开心的时候呢，她就不再关心她自己的容颜了。
And she wears dirty clothes, and she sits on the ground.
然后呢，她会穿脏的衣服。What is on the ground? Sorry, I missed her that.
The wife, she sits on the ground.
Okay, 这个妻子呢，她就会穿脏的衣服，然后就随便坐在地上。
So that's what Satyabhama would do sometimes, and that's what some of the gopis would do.
那这是萨迦巴玛有的时候会做的事情，勾皮们有时候也会这么做。
But what we see in the goddess of fortune in Jagannath Puri is very different.
但是呢，我们在 Jagannath Puri 所见到的幸运女神所展现出来的这番景象呢，又非常的不一样。
Yeah, this goddess of fortune becomes angry with her husband and she attacks him.
因为呢，幸运女神她就对她的丈夫现出极大的愤怒，而且呢还会去攻击他。
So Lord Chaitanya asked Swarup Damodar, "Please tell me about the varieties of egoistic pride that we see in Vrindavan."
所以呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对 Swarup Damodar 说呢，请你告诉我，我们在 Vrindavan 所能够见到的各种各样的自我展现的骄傲。
So Swarup Damodar said, "The pride of the gopis is like a river with many hundreds of tributaries."
然后，Swarup Damodar 说呢，在文达们我们所见到的 gopi 的这种愤怒呢，就好像是有很多支流的河流一样。
And the characteristics and type of love are different in different women.
而且呢，在不同的女子之间，她们会展现出不同的爱的特征。
And their jealous anger takes on different varieties and qualities.
而且呢，他们的那种醋意啊，以及他们的愤怒啊，会展现出各种各样的方式。
It's not possible to describe all of the gopis, all of their different anger, because so many different varieties.
但是呢，由于有太多种类了，所以呢，就没有办法描述出在文达们的 gopi 们展现出来的所有的愤怒的展现。
But we just try to describe a few of the prominent kind.
但是呢，我们就试着来描述其中主要的几种。
So he said, there are three types of women who experience jealous anger.
他说呢，有三种女子，她们在感受着醋意的愤怒。
There are, first of all, sober women.
那第一个呢，是冷静的女子。
And then there are restless women.
然后呢，就是躁动不安的女子。
And then there are women who are both restless and sober.
还有一种呢，就是这女人呢，她又冷静，但是呢，她又很躁动不安。
So when the woman is sober and she sees her lover coming from a distance, she will immediately stand up to receive him.
就是一位冷静的女子，当她从远处看到她的丈夫过来的时候呢，她立刻就会站起来去迎接他。不是她的丈夫，看到她的爱人过来的时候。
And she will give him a place to sit.
而且呢，她还会给他准备一个座位。
So she conceals her anger in her heart.
所以呢，她就会把她的这个愤怒呢，就藏在心里面。
And externally, she speaks nice, sweet words.
在外在呢，她还会讲述非常的美好的话语。
And when the lover embraces the woman, then she returns his embrace.
而且呢，当他的爱人在拥抱他的时候呢，他也会回应。
So this is we're describing the sober, the type of sober jealous anger. So the sober woman is very simple in her behavior.
所以刚才我们在讲述的是呢，就是头脑很冷静的女子她的表现。那她的这个表现呢是非常的简单的。
She keeps her jealous anger in her heart.
她呢就会把她的这种醋意的愤怒呢藏在她的心里。
And she'll speak mild words and she'll smile to her lover.
她呢会对她的爱人微笑，而且呢，她又会讲温柔的话。
But when her lover tries to make advances on her, she will reject him.
但是呢，当她的爱人要向她示爱意的时候呢，她会拒绝他。
Now, on the other hand, there's the restless type of jealous anger.
另外一方面呢，还有一种就是躁动不安的醋意的愤怒。
So she will chastise her lover. She'll speak cruel words.
那她呢就会斥责她的爱人，她会向他讲非常残忍的话。
And sometimes she'll pull his ear.
有的时候呢还会揪他的耳朵。
And sometimes she'll tie him up with a flower garland.
有的时候呢还会用花环把她的爱人给绑起来。
So this restless woman.Is a oh no, but now we're going to describe the other type of jealous anger, which is a combination of restlessness and being sober.
那然后呢，现在我们再解释一下，有另外一种啊，另外一种呢就是冷静和躁动不安相结合的醋意。
So she always jokes with different words.
那么这样的女孩呢，她就总是会用各种各样的话开玩笑。
Sometimes she will praise her lover, and sometimes she'll blaspheme him.
那有的时候呢，她就会赞扬她的爱人；有的时候呢，她又会说一些重话。
So these kind of women can be classified in different ways.
那么这些女子们呢，她们可以各种各样的方式给她们进行分类。
They can be called.One is captivated.
其中一种呢被称为叫被迷住的。
captivated, that means they don't know very much about the intricacies of jealous anger.
也就意味着呢，他们其实不是特别的理解关于醋意的愤怒的错综复杂性。
Yeah, this captivated woman, she'll just cover her face and go on crying.
那么这些被迷住的女子呢，她们做的事情就是把这脸给遮住，然后呢就到边去哭了。
And if she hears sweet words from her lover, she's very happy, she's satisfied.
那当她从她的爱人那听到了一些非常甜美的话语的时候呢，她就会感到很心满意足。
But then there's another type of woman who is, there's a type who is impudent, and then there's someone else who is intermediate. Between the captivated and the impudent, they're intermediate.
那还有一种呢，被称为叫是 impudent， 也叫轻飘。
Impudent. It means very cheeky.
Yeah， 就是 OK。还有另外一种呢，就是很会耍花招。那么就是还有一种呢，是在这个刚才说是被迷住的，还有一个很会耍花招的，他们俩人之间的那种，就是处于他们俩中间的那种。
So both the all their characteristics can be classified in three different divisions.
但是呢，所有的这些女子，她们都可以被分成三类。
Some of these women are very talkative, and some are mild, and some are equipoised.
那么，她们其中有些人呢，就话很多，还有一些呢是，很柔和，还有一种呢是，处于。很平静的状态。
Each of these ladies, according to their own character, give Krishna greater ecstasy.
那这些女子们呢，都是按照她们自己所具备的特征，给 Krishna 以巨大的狂喜的感受。
Some of the gopis are talkative.
有些 gopi 们呢，就会话很多。
And some are mild, and some are equipoised.
那么有一些人呢是很温和，然后还有一些呢就属于是很平静的状态。
But they're all transcendental, and they're all without any fault.
但是呢，他们都是处于超然层面的，而且呢，他们都是属于无错的状态的。
They give the greatest pleasure to Krishna by their very special characteristics.
他们都通过他们自己非常特别的这个特征的，让 Krishna 非常的开心。
So Lord Chaitanya was feeling so much happiness to hear all of this, and he asked for Rupa Damodar, please keep tell me more, keep talking.
所以当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到这些以后呢，他就感到很欢喜，然后呢，他就对 Swarupa Damodar 说呢，求你了，给我讲更多，别停下来，一直说下去。
So he said.Krishna is the master of all transcendental mellows.
然后Swarupa Damodar说呢，这个Krishna 他是所有的一切超然的情怀的主人。
And his body is made of transcendental bliss.
而且呢，他的身体呢就是由超然的极乐所构成的。
And Krishna is.Always under the control of the love of his devotees.
而且 Krishna 呢，他永远都是在他的奉献者的爱的控制之下的。
And the gopis are very experienced in pure love.
而 gopi 们呢是非常精通于纯粹之爱的。
And they're very experienced in the dealings of transcendental mellows.
而且呢，他们也非常的精于去处理这超然的情怀。
There's no fault in the love of the gopis.
所以说呢，在gopi 的爱中呢是没有任何缺点的，没有任何错误的。
So they give Krishna the greatest pleasure.
所以说呢，他们就这样让 Krishna 处于极度的欢乐之中。
Just like Lord Krishna enjoys the rasa dance, dancing with the gopis in the autumn season.
那就比如说在秋季的时候呢， Krishna 就非常的享受和 Gopi 们一起跳舞，跳 Rasa 之舞。
And he used poetic words and surrounded himself with women who were very much attracted to him.
那他呢就会用诗情画意的语言，并且呢在他的周围呢就会围绕着很多美丽的姑娘，而且这些姑娘们呢都是非常吸引他的。
So the gopis are all transcendental spirit souls.
但是这些 gopi 们呢，他们全都是超然的灵性的灵魂。
We should never think that gopis and Krishna have a material body.
那我们永远都不要认为 gopi 们以及 Krishna 他们有着物质的躯体。
And Vrindavan is also a spiritual place.
而且 Vrindavan 也是一个灵性的地方。
There in Vrindavan, the days and the nights and the trees and the flowers, everything is spiritual.
在 Vrindavan, 比如说日、夜、树、花，所有的一切都是灵性的。
There's no material contamination.
所以说呢，在 Vrindavan 是没有任何物质的污染的。
And Krishna is not interested in anything material.
而且 Krishna 呢，对于物质的东西，他一点也不感兴趣。
So Krishna's activities with the gopis are spiritual, and they all take place in the spiritual world.
所以说呢 ，Krishna 和 gopi 姑娘们，她们所从事的活动是灵性的，而且她们这灵性的活动呢，是在灵性世界发生的。
So Lord Krishna, although it appears like he has lusty desires, his dealings with the gopis are all on the spiritual platform.
那这主呢，他展现出来的好像是具有这个色欲的状态，但其实他和 Gopi 们所上演的这些逍遥时光所展现的这些活动，全部都是在灵性的层面上的。
So before we can appreciate these pastimes, we have to be on the transcendental platform.
所以说呢，在我们能够真正的欣赏这些逍遥时光之前，我们首先必须要让自己置于超然的层面。
So if we areOn the mundane platform, we have to purify ourselves by following the regulative principles.
对，如果我们现在还处在世俗的层面的话，那我们就必须要通过遵守四项规范原则，让自己被晋升到超人的层面才行。
Then we can try to understand the pastimes of Krishna and the gopis.
这样我们才能够试着去了解Krishna 和 Gopi 们之间的逍遥时光。
We should understand that when Lord Chaitanya is talking about these things, it's nothing mundane.
而且我们也应该理解，当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在讲述这些话题的时候，完全不是世俗的。
Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi, he was very strict in dealing with the other sex.
是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他是一位 sannyasi, 他对于接触异性来说是非常的严格的。
So unless the gopis were on the spiritual platform, Lord Chaitanya would never mention them.
所以除非这些 gopi 姑娘们是处于灵性的层面的，否则的话 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是不可能提及他们的。
So the gopis can be divided into two groups. There's the left-wing gopis and the right-wing gopis.
所以呢 gopi 姑娘们呢可以被分成两群，一群呢是属于左翼 gopi, 然后另外呢被属于是右翼 gopi。
So both wings, both sides, they cause Krishna to enjoy transcendental mellows.
那这两群 gopi 们，他们其实都会让 Krishna 享受超然的情怀。
And they show different signs of ecstatic love.
而且呢，他们会展现不同的极乐的征象。
And of all the gopis, Radharani is the chief.
那在所有的这些 gopi 姑娘们中呢 ，Radharani 是领头。
And she's the source of all transcendental conjugal mellows.
而且呢，她也是所有的超然的情侣之爱的源头。
She's always deeply absorbed in ecstatic love.
所以说呢，他也总是时刻都让自己非常深的沉浸在，超人的爱的密路之中。
And she is a left-wing gopi.
那么是 Mata Radharani 呢？她是属于左翼 gopi.
So we'll tell about the, what's the different qualities. The left-wing gopi is described, the left-wing gopi, like Radharani, is one who's always eager to be jealous, jealously angered.
那我们来说一说这一组以勾比和右翼勾比之间的区别。那么以 Radharani 为首的这一组一比他所展现的特征呢，就是他总是展现出那种渴望，而且呢也总是很愤怒，然后会有这种醋意。
And she's very enthusiastic for that position.
而且呢他对于就是他所处在的这个位置呢，他也是
She will immediately become angered to get, she'll get very angry when she's defeated.
就是当她被击败的时候呢，她会展现出立刻的愤怒。
And she can never be under the control of her lover.
而且呢，她也永远都不会受制于她的爱人的控制。
Anybody or anybody who opposes him.Is also, if they oppose also Krishna, then they're also a left-wing gopi.
就是任何是 Krishna 的对立面的人，他也是属于左翼的 gopi.
But the right-wing gopi is the girl who cannot tolerate, she cannot tolerate anger, womanly anger.
但是呢，左翼右翼 gopi 呢？是属于他们是完全不能容忍愤怒的，就完全不能容忍姑娘们所展现出来的那种生气的。
And she speaks kind words to her lover.
这右翼勾品呢，她是会对她的爱人讲柔情似水的话。
And she's satisfied with his sweet words.
而且呢，她也会被甜美的话语而感到心满意足。
So that's a right wing gopi.
所以呢，这是右翼 gopi。
So Radharani is a left-wing gopi. Her anger is always awakening.
所以 Srimati Radharani 呢，她属于左翼 gopi， 所以她的愤怒呢，时刻都处于醒着的状态。
But Krishna gets a lot of bliss from her activities.
但是呢，是 Krishna 就从 Srimati Radharani 的这个行为举止中得到很多的极乐的感觉。
Yeah, the affairs between a young boy and a young girl is always crooked. It's like the movement of a snake.
那就是年轻的男孩跟女孩他们之间的这种互动呢，总是有一些狡猾的色彩在这里面，就好像是蛇的移动一样。
So you get two types of anger between the young boy and the young girl.
所以呢，我们在年轻的男孩女孩之间呢，会讲到两种类型的愤怒。
You get anger which has a cause and anger which doesn't have a cause.
一种愤怒呢，就是有原因的愤怒，还有另外一种呢，是没有原因的愤怒。
So Radharani's love is a very advanced, highly advanced ecstasy.
那 Srimati Radharani 对 Sri Krishna 的爱呢，是一种非常。高境界的极乐。
Her dealings are 10 times purer than gold.
她的 Srimati Radharani 的这些行为活动要比金子还要纯十倍。
All of her dealings are completely pure.
所以 Srimati Radharani 她所从事的任何一个活动都是完全的纯净的。
As soon as Radharani gets a chance to see Krishna, her body is suddenly decorated with different kinds of ecstatic emotions.
当Srimati Radharani 一有机会要见到 Sri Krishna 的时候，她的身体立刻就会被十种不同的极乐的真相所点缀。
And these are all described. If you read in the Nectar of Devotion, all of these things are described.
如果我们要是阅读《风爱的甘露》的话呢，所有的这些细节都在里面有很都有描述。
There are many different kinds of ecstatic emotions.
有很多种类的极乐的情感。
And they have a lot. There's a lot of technical names describing them.
所以呢，就是对于这些不同的这些情感的展示呢，有很多技术性的名词去解释它们。
So Krishna feels great happiness when he meets these different things, when he sees these different feelings in Radharani.
所以说呢，当 Sri Krishna 他看到 Sri Mati Radharani 所展现出来的这个不同的这些感受情感的时候呢。Sri Krishna 是非常的开心的。
Yeah, it's these ecstasies, these different emotions which Radharani displays, which attract Krishna.
因为呢，Sri Mati Radharani 他所展现出来的不同的情感、不同的极乐，都非常的吸引 Sri Krishna.
So when Krishna sees Radharani, and he wants to touch her body, he will stop her from going to the place where she can cross the river Yamuna.
那所以说呢，当 Sri Krishna 想要触碰 Sri Mati Radharani 的这个身体的时候呢，那么他不会，他就会阻止 Sri Mati Radharani 过河，渡过亚穆纳河。
And sometimes when Radharani is picking flowers, then Krishna will stop her from picking flowers.
而且有的时候，当 Sri Mati Radharani 在采花的时候呢 ，Sri Krishna 也会阻止他，不要他采花。
And sometimes Krishna will also touch Radharani in front of all of her friends.
而且有的时候呢 ，Sri Krishna 就会当着 Sri Mati Radharani 的很多朋友的面去碰他。
So these different pastimes they bring out different ecstatic emotions in Radharani.
那就是所有的这些不同的逍遥时光呢，就会。带出 Sri Mati Radharani 的各种的极乐的情感。
There will be ecstatic love displayed.
所以呢 ，Sri Mati Radharani 就会展现出极乐的爱的真相。
So whenever Radharani leaves her house, she's always well dressed and very attractive.
每次当 Sri Mati Radharani 出门的时候呢，她都会穿着的非常的美丽。
So she attracts Krishna's attention.
她就会吸引到 Sri Krishna 的注意。
Krishna sees her so attractively dressed. He wants to touch her, to touch her body.
那么 Sri Krishna 看着她打扮得如此漂亮，所以呢就被她吸引，所以呢就想碰她，想碰她的身体。
So he will find Krishna will find some fault with her.And he will stop her from going to cross the river.
So, Sri Krishna 呢就会在 Sri Mati Radharani 的身上挑错，从而呢阻止她渡河，渡过亚穆纳河。
Or he will stop her from picking flowers.
或者说呢，就阻止她不要再摘花了。
This is the pastimes between Krishna and Radharani.
这个呢就是 Sri Krishna 和 Radharani 之间的逍遥。
Because Radharani is a cowherd girl.So she has to take the milk. She carries the milk in a container, and she has to go to sell the milk on the market on the other side of the Yamuna.
那因为 Sri Mati Radharani 她是一位牧牛女，所以说呢，她就必须要用牛奶，就是乳牛所提供的这个牛奶制成奶制品，然后呢，把这个奶制品带到亚穆纳河的对岸去把它给卖了。
And she has to cross the river, and she's supposed to pay the boatman.
那他如果是过河的话呢，他就得付钱给船夫载他过河。
And when the boatman collects the fare, that is called dana gati.
当这个船夫他收取了船票的钱之后呢，这个被称为叫 dana gati.
So Krishna stops her from going, and he tells her, first you have to pay to me.
然后呢 ，Sri Krishna 就会拦住他，并且对他说：“首先你先把钱付给我。”
So this is called the Dana Keli Lila.
那这个呢就被称为叫 Dana Keli 的逍遥。
So Radharani, when Srimati Radharani wants to pick a flower, Krishna will say, "This garden's my property. You cannot do it."
那所以当 Sri Mati Radharani 他想要在花园里面摘花的时候 Sri Krishna 就会说这个花园是属于我的所以说呢你不能在这儿摘花
So Radharani will become shy because Krishna is stopping her
那因为 Krishna 阻止了他那这会儿 Radharani 呢就会变得很腼腆
So this is another ecstasy which Krishna enjoys
那这是Krishna 他非常享受的另外一种极乐。
So there's a lot of description about the different symptoms which are given in the emotions of Radharani.
那这里面呢就有很多的关于 Srimati Radharani 他在情绪上所显现出来的真相的描述。
These emotions are like a combination, they're like a combination of yogurt and candy, ghee and honey.
那所有的这些情绪呢，就好像是，酸奶，饼干和蜂蜜所混合起来的这样的情感。
Ghee, as well as ghee.
Sorry, 不是蜜蜂，不是蜂蜜，是酥油。
Yeah, ghee and black pepper.
还有黑胡椒。
And camphor.
还有樟脑。
And cardamom.
还有卡达门。
And they're all mixed together. It's very tasty and sweet.
就是把所有的这些佐料全部都给它混在一起，就非常的美味，非常的甜美。
So Lord Krishna is thousands and thousands of times more satisfied when he sees Radharani's face light up.
Shri Krishna, 他看到 Shri Mati Radharani 的脸绽放着光彩的时候，那他就会感受到成千上万倍的满足。
Yeah, her face will light up when she's in contact, direct contact with Krishna.
当 Shri Mati Radharani 和 Krishna 相接触之后呢，他的脸就会绽放出光彩。
So when Lord Krishna would block Radharani's way, there would be laughter in the heart of Radharani.
当 Shri Krishna 他堵住了 Shri Mati Radharani 的路的时候呢， Shri Mati Radharani 他内心是在笑的。
And her eyes will grow bright, and fresh tears will come from her eyes.
但是呢，他的这个眼睛就会发亮。然后呢，泪水就会从她的眼睛里面流淌而出。
And because she has a very sweet relationship with Krishna, then her eyes will be enthusiastic and her crying will stop.
但是呢，就是由于她和 Sri Krishna 有这种非常甜美的关系，所以说她的眼睛就会变得非常的热情，然后呢，她的泪就会被止住了。
So at that time, she appeared even more beautiful.
那就在这里呢，她这心就更加的美丽动人。
Sometimes when she's agitated, Radharani's eyes will be tinged with red.
但有的时候，当 Sri Radharani 很激动的时候呢，她的这个眼睛里面就会泛红。
And her lips will begin to move with jubilation.
然后呢，她的这个双唇就会在快乐中颤动。
And her lotus face will smile.
然后她的莲花脸庞就会绽放出笑容。
And when Krishna sees all of this, then he will feel millions of times happier.
那么当时 Krishna 看到这景象的时候呢，他的快乐就会增加百万倍。
He feels even happier seeing her than when he was embracing her.
那然后当他看到这么开心的时候，他就会去拥抱他。
So Lord Krishna's happiness is not at all mundane.
但是呢，所以这单单嘛，所以 Krishna 的他的这个行为呢，完全不是世俗化的。
So Lord Chaitanya is getting so much pleasure to hear all of this.
所以当听到所有的这些信息的时候呢，所以这单单嘛，巴布是非常的欢喜的。
So he asked Swarup Damodar, tell me about the different emotions which Radharani attracts, by which Radharani attracts the mind of Krishna.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对 Swarup Damodar 说呢，请你告诉我，Sri Mati Radharani 都有哪些情感会吸引 Krishna.
So all the devotees were very happy to hear this.
当时所有的奉献者们都非常的开心能够听到这些信息。
And said, sometimes Radharani is sitting. Sometimes when Radharani is sitting, or when she's going to Vrindavan, she sees Krishna.
他就说呢 ，Sri Mati Radharani 有的时候会坐在那里，或者说当他去到 Vrindavan 的时候呢，他就会去看 Krishna。
So at that time, the symptoms of different ecstasies will be shown in her body.
那么在那会儿的时候呢，在 Sri Mati Radharani 的身上就会展示各种各样极乐的征象。
These different symptoms manifest in the woman's face, or in her eyes, or other parts of her body.
那么，这种极乐的征象呢，就会展现在这个女子的脸上、她的眼睛上，以及她的身体的其他的部位。
Maybe the way she stands, or the way she meets her lover.
或者是她站她的站姿，以及她和她的爱人相见的那个情景。
So the left-wing gopis, they will be sometimes timid and jubilant and respectful.
那么这个左翼的勾评呢，他们有的时候呢会显得有一些胆怯，有的时候呢会显得很快乐，有的时候呢又显得很有尊敬心。
And sometimes they're ambitious.
但有的时候呢，他们又显得很，激进。
And sometimes fear.
有的时候就会显现出恐惧。
So when Radharani saw Krishna just before her, in front of her, she stopped, and she took the attitude of the opposition.
所以呢，当 Sri Mati Radharani 看到 Krishna 在他的面前或者向他走过来的时候呢，那么他就会停下来，他就会停止下来，并且呢，让自己处于和 Sri Krishna 相对立的状态。
So her face was covered with her blue cloth, her blue sari.
那她的脸庞呢，是被她蓝色的纱丽的这个面巾给遮住的。
And her two eyes were agitated and wide.
那这会儿呢，他的两只眼睛就会很不安，然后呢，会睁得很大。
So her beauty increased to give pleasure to Krishna.
那这会儿呢，他的美就会更加的加深，从而呢，就会让 Sri Krishna 非常的开心，更加的开心。
When Radharani stands in front of Krishna, she's bent in three places.
那当 Radharani 站在 Sri Krishna 的面前的时候呢，他的身体有三个地方会打弯。
Her neck, her waist, and her legs.
一个呢是她的脖子，还有呢她的腰部，还有她的双腿。
And her eyebrows dance.
她的双眉会跳舞。
So the eyes of Radharani are appropriate for a woman. They're very appropriate. They're very charming.
Sri Mati Radharani 的双眼呢是非常的迷人的。
Her bodily features are very delicate, and
她的身 ，sorry.
Yeah, go ahead.
她的身体的她的这个身体呢也是非常的婀娜的。
And she has ornaments of feminine charm.
她带着feminine charm 就是她带着这个女性特征的饰品。
So Krishna sees Radharani decorated with all of these ornaments.
那么当时 Krishna 看着 Sri Mati Radharani 浑身都点缀着所有的这些饰品的时候。
So Krishna always wants to, they always want to meet each other.
那 Sri Krishna 和 Sri Mati Radharani 他们总想彼此之间相互能够见面。
So these different when Krishna came forward, he sometimes will snatch the border of Radharani's sari.
当他们要相见的时候呢，就他们两人相会的时候，Sri Krishna 他有的时候就会拽住 Srimati Rani 的沙里的一边一截儿。
And Radharani, actually, she's very pleased, but she will try to stop him.
但是其实 Srimati Rani 的内心是非常的开心的，但是呢，她要假装的制止 Krishna.
This is another ecstasy.
这是另外一种极乐的感受。
And when the border of her sari and the cloth which is covering her face are caught, then she appears offended and angry.
当 Srimati Rani 的沙里的这个边角这个地方，还有她的遮她的脸的这个面纱被扯开的时候呢，那么 Srimati Rani 她就会展现出很愤怒的样子。
But within her heart, she's very happy.
但是在他内心里面，他觉得特别的开心。
So although Radharani was trying to stop Krishna with her hands, internally she was thinking, "Let Krishna satisfy his desires."
虽然说Srimati Rani 在用手在阻止 Krishna 不要这么做，但其实在他内心里面，他在想让 Krishna 满足他的内心的愿望吧。
So she was actually very pleased, although she was appearing to be angry.
所以说呢，虽然 Srimati Rani 她表现出来好像很愤怒，但她其实是很开心的。
Yeah, she was like crying as if she was offended.
她外在表现出她在哭，好像是她被冒犯了，被欺负了。
But she will chastise Krishna.
然后呢，她会斥责 Krishna.
Actually, she has no desire to stop Krishna.
但其实他并没有真的想要阻止 Krishna.
Krishna wants to touch her body with his hands, and she doesn't want to stop him.
因为 Krishna 想用他的手去触碰 Srimati Rani 的身体，其实 Srimati Rani 是不想阻止 Krishna 的。
But she stops. She protests, and she tells him off. She says, "Don't do this."
但是呢。Srimati Rani 他外在的表现呢，就是他会停下来，然后呢，他会阻止 Krishna， 并且跟他说别怎么弄，别弄了。
So in this way, Radharani attracts the mind of Lord Krishna.
所以就以这样的方式呢 ，Srimati Rani 吸引着 Sri Krishna 的心意。
So then, Srivastakur is coming. Srivastakur was there.And he said to Swarup Damodar, he said, just see the opulence of the goddess of fortune.
然后这会儿呢 Srivastakur 进来了，然后呢，他对Swarup Damodar 说，看看幸运女神她所具有的富裕，她所拥有的富裕。
And Srivastakur said, Vrindavan's opulence is only a few flowers.And some minerals from the hills and a few peacock feathers.
那他说，你看啊，在这个文达本的拥有的富裕呢，不过就是一些鲜花，还有在山里面的一些矿物品，或者是一些孔雀羽毛而已。
And Lord Jagannath wanted to go and see Vrindavan. He went there, and the goddess of fortune.Became restless and jealous.
Jagannath, 他想去看看文达本，然后他们就去了。然后这样呢，就使得幸运女神变得很嫉妒，变得很不安。
Yeah, she's thinking, why does Jagannath give so much importance to Vrindavan?
他就在想，为什么 Jagannath 要这么的重视文达本呢？
Then the goddess of fortune had so much opulence in her place.Why he wants to go to Vrindavan?
而幸运女神在她的居住地有这么多的富裕，那为什么主教呢？他还要想去 Vrindavan 呢？
When Lord Jagannath gave up the opulence of the goddess of fortune, and just for a few days went to Vrindavan.
而且呢，主教呢，他就放弃了幸运女神的富裕。而且花几天的时间去 Vrindavan.
And in Vrindavan, there's just some fruits and flowers.
可是在 Vrindavan 就只不过有一些果子和一些鲜花而已。
He just goes there to see the flower garden, the garden of Radharani.
只不过到那去看一看 Radharani 的花园。
So Srivas Thakur said, your master is so expert at everything. Why does he do these things?
然后呢 Srivas Thakur 就说你的主人、非常精到于所有的这些事情那他为什么还要这么做呢
Bring him before the goddess of fortune.
赶紧把他给带到幸运女神身边来吧。
So the maidservants of the goddess of fortune, they arrest all the servants of Lord Jagannath.
然后呢，幸运女神的仆人们就把主加格纳达的所有的仆人们全部都给抓起来了。
And they bring them before the goddess of fortune.
然后呢，他们就把这些被抓起来的仆人给带到了幸运女神的面前。
And they were all fined, and they were forced to surrender to the goddess of fortune.
他们全都被迫要向幸运女神臣服。
And all the maid servants began to beat.The Rathyatra car with sticks.
所有的这些女仆们们呢，就开始用棍儿来击打弹车。
And they treated all the servants of Lord Jagannath like they were thieves.
他们就像对待贼一样对待主加格纳达的仆人们。
So finally, all of Lord Jagannath's servants surrender to the goddess of fortune.
终于呢，主加格纳达的仆人们就全部都向幸运女神投降了。
And they promise we're going to bring Lord Jagannath back to you very soon.
然后他们就承诺说呢，我们很快会把主加格纳达带到您身边来的。
Yeah, we'll try to come tomorrow.
我们尽量明天就回来。
So the goddess of fortune was a little pacified.
那这会儿呢，幸运女神稍微得到了一点安慰。
And so Srivas Thakur said this, that my goddess of fortune is so opulent.
然后 Srivas Thakur 就说呢，幸运女神拥有这么多富裕。
And see, Srivas Thakur, he is an incarnation of Narada Muni, so he thinks in terms of Vaikuntha.
那因为 Srivas Thakur 呢，他是 Narada Muni 的化身。所以说他的这个想法呢，其实是百昆特的那种思维。
So Srivas said, he said, you know, he says to Swarup Namandar, said, your gopis, they're just doing things like boiling milk and making yogurt.
然后呢，他 Srivas Thakur 对 Swarup Namandar 说呢，你的在 Vrindavan 的这些 gopi 们，他们只不过呢是在煮牛奶，在做酸奶而已。
But the goddess of fortune, she sits on a throne made of jewels and gems.
但是幸运女神，她会坐在由珠宝砌成的王座之上。
So this way, Srivas was enjoying the mood of Narada Muni because Narada Muni is a Vaikuntha man.
那所以就以这样的方式呢，塔库尔他就在享受着 Narada Muni 的这种心绪，因为 Narada Muni 呢，他是一位从
So all the devotees were listening and they were laughing.
所有的这些奉献者们就在边上听着，然后笑着。
So Lord Chaitanya says to Srivas, he said, Srivas, your nature is just like Narada Muni.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Srivas Thakur 说 ，Srivas， 你的特征就像 Narada Muni 一样。
Yeah, the opulence of the Supreme Lord is having an influence upon you.
也就是说呢。至尊主的富裕的特征在你身上是有影响的。
Swarup Damodar is a pure devotee of Vrindavan. He doesn't know about opulence.
Swarup Damodar 是Vrindavan 的纯粹奉献者，所以说呢，他对于百昆达的这种富裕是一无所知的。
He is only absorbed in pure devotional service.
他完全是沉醉在。纯粹的奉爱服务之中的。
So Swarup Damodar says to Srivas, he said, let me tell you about the opulence of Vrindavan.
然后呢 ,Swarup Damodar 就对 Srivas Thakur 说让我来给你讲一讲在 Vrindavan 所拥有的富裕。
Somebody was saying yesterday, they thought they wanted to be in Dwarka Leela, they didn't want to be in Vrindavan Leela. They thought Vrindavan Leela is the countryside, the village. They thought better to be in Dwarka with the opulence.
昨天有奉献者就说呢，他 他最好还是就处在 Dwark 的逍遥时光中，而不要去到 Vrindavan 的逍遥时光，因为 Vrindavan 呢只不过就是一些这个乡村之地而已，而 Dwark 呢是城市，所以呢最好就还是在 Dwark 的逍遥时光里吧。
So we have to understand the opulence of Vrindavan.
所以呢我们必须要理解 Vrindavan 所拥有的富裕是什么。
Actually, the opulence of Dwarka and Vaikuntha doesn't compare to even a drop of the opulence of Vrindavan.
事实上呢，在 Dwarka 所拥有的富裕，或者在 Vaikuntha 所拥有的富裕，和在 Vrindavan 所拥有的富裕的一个点滴都比不上。
Krishna enjoys all of his opulences completely only in Vrindavan.
因为 Krishna 他只有在 Vrindavan 的时候才能够完全的去享受他的富裕。
Vrindavan is made of touchstones.
Vrindavan 是由点金石构成的。
The whole surface of Vrindavan is valuable jewels.
整个 Vrindavan 的表面全部都覆盖着宝石。
And there's
非常珍贵的宝石。
Chintamani stones to decorate the lotus feet of the maidservants of Vrindavan.
在 Vrindavan 主的仆人的莲花足就是由 Chintamani 的点金石所点缀。
And in Vrindavan there are desired trees and anything you want, any kind of fruit or flower at any time can be obtained from these desired trees.
在 Vrindavan 的树都是如愿树，你想得到的任何一种花朵。任何一种果实都可以从这些如愿树中得到。
And in Vrindavan, there are cows that fulfill all of our desires.
在 Vrindavan 的乳牛能够满足我们所有的愿望。
And these cows are unlimited in number.
而且呢，这些乳牛的数量是数不胜数的。
The people only want milk, so the cows they just give milk.
而且呢，人们是希望想要牛奶，所以呢，乳牛就会给大家提供牛奶。
Just like the desire trees, the people only want fruit and flowers. They don't desire anything else.
那就好像是，从如愿树上，人们想得到的只不过就是果实和鲜花而已，人们并不想要别的。
And then the speech of the people in Vrindavan is just like music.
在 Vrindavan 的人们，他们的讲话就好像是动听的音乐一样。
And every motion they make is like a dance.
他们所移动的每一个动作都好像是在跳舞。
And the water in Vrindavan is all nectar.
在 Vrindavan 的所有的水都是蜜露。
And in Vrindavan, you can directly see the Brahmajyoti.
而在 Vrindavan 你能够直接见到 Brahmajyoti。
All the gopis are all goddesses of fortune.
在 Vrindavan 的所有的 gopi 们全部都是幸运女神。
And they're much greater than these goddesses of fortune who live in Vaikuntha.
所以呢，他们要比居住在 Vaikuntha 的这些幸运女神们要伟大得多。
So Lord Krishna always plays his flute for the pleasure of his devotees.
在 Vrindavan, Sri Krishna 总是为了要取悦他的奉献者们而吹奏着笛子。
Krishna is the enjoyer in Vrindavan.
Krishna 是 Vrindavan 的享受者。
And he enjoys the Kalpavriksha trees, he enjoys the cows, he enjoys the Chintamani touchstone.
而且呢，他也会非常的享受这些 Kalpavriksha 树，就是如愿树，以及Chintamani的点金石，还有享受这些乳牛们。
And Krishna's constant companion is his flute.
那 Krishna 恒常不断的陪伴呢，就是他的笛子。
So when Srivastakur heard all of this, he began to dance in ecstasy.
所以当 Srivastakur 听到这些的时候呢，他就开始在极乐中跳起舞来。
And he was slapping his armpits with the palm of his hands and laughing loudly.
而且呢，他还用他的这个手掌去拍他的腋下，然后呢，会大声的笑着。
So Lord Chaitanya was hearing these discussions. He was very happy.
当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到所有的这些探讨的时候呢，他就特别的开心。
And Lord Chaitanya got up and began to dance.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 也站起身来，开始跳起舞来。
As Swarup Damodar was singing, Lord Chaitanya was dancing.
Swarup Damodar 呢就唱起歌，然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 开始翩就是翩翩起舞。
And Lord Chaitanya told him, "Go on, keep singing, keep singing."
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Swarup Damodar 说呢，继续唱，继续唱。
So Lord Chaitanya was tasting the nectar of the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就这样在品味着 Sri Krishna 的小时光。
And although he was in Jagannath Puri, he was experiencing the mood of Vrindavan.
那虽然说他是身在 Jagannath Puri, 但他在体验着、感受着在 Vrindavan 的逍遥。
So finally, the goddess of fortune went back to her place, her residence.
那终于呢，幸运女神就回到了她自个儿的府邸。
And Lord Chaitanya and the devotees continued to do their sankirtan.
然后，Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢和这些奉献者们继续进行了他们的 sankirtan.
Lord Chaitanya was absorbed in Srimati Radharani's love for Krishna.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 完全沉醉在 Srimati Radharani 对 Krishna 的爱的心绪之中。
And Lord Chaitanya actually appeared in the form of Radharani.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他其实是在 Srimati Radharani 的形象下显现的。
And when Lord Nityananda saw this, then Lord Nityananda offered prayers to her.
当主 Nityananda 看到这一点的时候呢，主 Nityananda 就像他，就是 Srimati Radharani 献上了祷恩。
Seeing the love, seeing Lord Chaitanya's love, Lord Nityananda kept a distance away. He didn't go close.
那么当他看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所展现的这个爱的真相的时候呢，朱尼提安南达就离他有一段距离，他就没有走到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的跟前。
Only Lord Nityananda could actually understand this pastime of Lord Chaitanya.
因为只有朱尼提安南达他才能够真正的理解 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他这个逍遥的情绪。
Anyway, the kirtan has to come to an end, and then Swarup Damodar saw all the devotees were tired, and they asked everyone to go back to their place.
那无论如何呢，这个 kirtan 也必须有结束的时候。Swarup Damodar 呢，看到所有的奉献者们也都累了。所以呢，他就请奉献者们回到各自的家里面去休息。
So Lord Chaitanya took his rest for some time, and then they brought prasadam. After they'd taken a bath, then they had their prasadam.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢休息了一会儿，然后呢，他们就沐浴，沐浴之后呢，他们就开始领用 prasadam。
And then Lord Chaitanya would go and see Lord Jagannath again, and again more kirtan, dancing.
然后呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢要再去拜见主 Jagannath， 然后呢，他们会有更多的 kirtan， 更多的舞蹈。
And then they took bath in the lake again, and more pastimes in the lake, throwing water on each other.
然后呢，他们又会到湖里边去沐浴，然后呢，就会在湖里面上演更多的游戏的逍遥时光。他们会在湖里面继续的玩水。
And so this went on for 8 days.And then finally it came time for Lord Jagannath to go back to his residence, back to Nilachala.
所以呢，就这样，他们一共持续了八天，直到主 Jagannath 要回到他自个儿的家里面去了，要回到 Nilachala 去了。
So they have the one Rathiatra going to Gundicha, and then they have the return Rathiatra bringing the deities back to Nilachala.
所以说呢，就是有两个贪车节，一个贪车节呢是要把主 Jagannath 要从 Jagannath 的庙给送到 Gundicha， 但是还有一个是返回的 Radhayatra， 就是要把主 Jagannath 从 Gundicha 庙要送回到 Jagannath 庙去。
So when they were bringing the deities off the chariot to take them back into the temple, at that time the ropes which they were using to move the deities, the ropes broke.
所以就是当奉献者们把神像从神坛上给请下来，然后呢要把他们给送回到原来地方的时候，就是他们运这个拉这个神像有根绳子，那么这根绳子这种就断了。
So Lord Chaitanya called for a couple of devotees and he asked them, he told them, he said, every year can you please bring good strong ropes which we can use to move the deities.
然后呢所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就召集了一些奉献者，并且对奉献者们说，你们每年能不能为我们提供一些非常好的质量的绳，从而呢让我们有好的绳子能够移动神像。
And Lord Chaitanya showed them the broken ropes. He said, you have to make ropes which are stronger than this one.
然后呢Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就把这个断了的绳子给他们看，说呢你们必须要做一些更加的结实的绳子。
And Lord Chaitanya told them, he said, these ropes are actually the abode of Lord Shesha.
然后Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 跟他们说呢，就这个绳子其实是主 Shesha 的居所。 Sorry, Maharaj, could you say it again? These ropes are the...
That they're actually the abode of Lord Shesha.
Okay, 就他们说这个绳子呢其实是主 Shesha 的居所。
And Lord Shesha, Ananta Shesha, he takes 10 forms for the service of Krishna.
Ananta Shesha, 主 Shesha 的他是以十种形式在服务着主 Krishna.
Just like... Krishna's shoes, and Krishna's ornaments, Krishna's pillow, Krishna's seat, these kind of things.
就比如说像Sri Krishna 的鞋子，他的饰品，然后呢，他的枕头，还有他的座位等等。
Yeah. So when they got the order from Lord Chaitanya, these two devotees were very pleased that they had been given a direct instruction from Lord Chaitanya.
那就是这两位得到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 要做绳子的这个训谕之后呢，就特别的开心，因为他们从 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 这儿得到了直接的训谕。
And so in this way, every year they would bring the silk ropes.
所以就以这样的方式呢，每一年他们都会为弹车节带来丝质的绳子。
Okay, so that's the end of the Rathyatra pastimes description.
所以呢。所以这样呢，就结束了对弹车节的小时光的讲述。
Yeah. So, are there any questions?
Yeah, yes. Maharaj, there are still a couple of questions from the
this morning
time.
Yeah.
Subhirayapabu, 就是有一个问题，我还没来得及把它给粘下来，咱们今天早上就被断掉了。所以您能找到吗？我现在先读数 Mukhiwala 几个问题。Sorry, I grabbed my phone. The question is in the phone.
Uh-huh. Are you at home?
Yes. Okay, the question from Sumukhi Radha Mataji this morning. She said that, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和奉献者们，请问我们是把食物供奉给 Guru 和圣帕帕德，通过 Guru 供奉给 Krishna, 还是直接供奉给 Krishna 呢？Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances and to all the devotees. My question is that when we offer the food, do we offer the food through Guru and Srila Prabhupada, then to the Lord, or we just offer the food to the Lord Krishna directly?
We offer to the Guru and then to Prabhupada and then to Krishna.
那我们这个食物是这样的，是先供给。Guru, 然后呢通过 Guru 给 Sri Prabhupada, 然后才给 Sri Krishna 的。
Right. When we are offering, we offer prayers first to the Guru, right? We offer our Guru Pranam Mantra, and then we offer, obviously also Prabhupada's Pranam Mantra, and then we will offer prayers to Lord Chaitanya, and then we offer prayers to Krishna.
对，就我们念诵祷文的时候也是这样的，我们先念的是 Guru 的顶拜祷文，然后呢是 Srila Prabhupada 的顶拜祷文，然后呢是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的祷文，然后才是 Krishna 的祷文。
Yeah, so we don't go directly to Krishna, we go through the disciplic succession.
所以说呢，我们不是直接去 Krishna 那儿的，我们是通过我们的使徒传系去的。
Yes.
Gati Prada Maji, 我知道您上午也问了一个问题，但是我没有来得及把那问题给摘下来，所以说这个晚上网就断掉了。您要是还想问那个问题的话，麻烦您再发一遍行吗？不好意思啊。然后下面这个问题是 Das 的。四月苦行是印度传统还是经典的原则？ The question from Das.This Prabhu asked that for the Chaturmasi, is that the Indian tradition or the regulation or the principles from the Shastra?
It's definitely Shastric.
那这个毫无疑问，这肯定是经典里有的。
Yeah, it's mentioned during the 4 months of the rainy season. At that time, the Lord is taking rest.
因为呢，就是在四月苦行的这个雨季的这个期间呢，主是要休息的。
So yes, it's in the Shastra.
所以说呢，这个是在经典里的原则。
And we see even in the Buddhism, the Buddhists also have 4 months of austerity.
啊，然后我们要是看佛教他们的这个修行呢，他们也有四月的苦行的。
I was in Taiwan, we would often go to a program. Every year these Buddhist monks, they would have a program at the end of their 4 months of austerity.
那就是我们在台湾的时候呢，有的时候呢就会去参加一些这个活动，然后就去看这个，就是参加一些佛教徒的活动。那这些这个僧人们，他们就刚刚结束他们这四月苦行。
Okay.
下面有些是印度传统，不是经典规定；有些是经典规定，不是印度传统；有些既是经典规定，又是印度传统。如何区分是经典的规定还是印度传统呢 ？Well, some of the things are from the Indian tradition. Some of them are Shastric principles, but some of them are the Shastric principles but not the Indian tradition. However, some of them are theBoth of the Shastric principles and also the Indian tradition. So how can we really clarify which is which? How can we really know is this a Shastric or is Indian tradition?
Well, we're following the orders of the spiritual teachers.
就我们呢，其实是追随着我们灵性导师的训练。
So whatever like our founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada, whatever Prabhupada taught us to follow, we follow that.
就比如说我们的创办灵性导师是 Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada 他让我们遵循的任何的规定，我们就去遵循。
And so we don't question, is this tradition, is this Indian or is this what? It's the order of the spiritual master, we follow it.
所以说呢，我们不会到底去质疑这到底是印度的呀，还是经典的，还是什么？我们只是去追随灵性导师让我们去做的事情就好了。
Yes。
下面一个问题：主 Chaitanya 遵守四月苦行吗？If Lord Chaitanya followed the Chaturmasis?
Yes, he did very strictly.
主 Chaitanya 妈妈是非常严格的遵循的。
We heard when he was in South India, he was one time he was at Sri Rangam, and it was just the beginning of Chaturmasya. So they told him, come and please stay here, don't travel anymore, come and stay for 4 months. So he did.
那我们有一个这个逍遥时光里面，就是他到了 Sri Rangam. 那么这会儿呢，就是四月苦行刚开始的时候，然后呢，他被告知的就是在这儿哪儿也不要去了。就在这儿要度过这四月苦行，所以说呢，所以查太监妈妈不就在那儿待着，就哪儿也没去。
Yes.
然后呢，就上午的问题哈 ，Gati Pradham 啊，谢谢 Subira Prabhu。他说顶拜 Guru Day 这个月不能喝牛奶，如果用牛奶做甜品，可以服务奉献者吗？Maji asked that this month we're not supposed to drink milk, but if it's okay for us to use the milk to process the sweets、
yes.
to serve devotees.
Yeah, you can do that.
你可以这么做。
Okay.
然后他问阿贝是 Asafoetida powder 吗？
Asafoetida, yes, right. It's the same as hing.
Okay, 对对，这个阿魏就是这个 Asafoetida 粉。是的，是的，是的。然后呢，是云娜的问题。Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. How to explain that there is no need to become attached to this world to those people who are not yet ready to renounce this world, who still hope to find pleasure in it? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我谦卑的顶拜，所有的荣耀都归于Srila Prabhupada。如何解释无需变得依附于这个世界，就如何像那些还没有准备弃绝这个世界，依然对这个世界还有很多的要找寻快乐的希望的人去解释，我们不需要依恋于这个世界。
So let them have prasadam and let them chant Hare Krishna.
那就让这些人荣耀 prasadam 和唱诵 Hare Krishna 就好了。
And then those two activities will help them to progress.
因为呢，就是这两个行为就可以帮助他们进步。
They're not ready to take up Krishna consciousness fully, but at least let them purify themselves by hearing the holy name, chanting, and by taking prasadam.
因为呢，他们其实还没有准备好要接受 Krishna 知觉，但是呢，可以通过聆听到圣名以及荣耀 prasadam 能够让他们得到净化。然后下面是王苏莹吗？这个问题，顶拜咕噜，请问经典中提到的 Kailash Mountain 是不是冈仁波切峰 ？The answer is yes. She is asking that if the Kailash is 冈仁波切 ，that is a Chinese name of that place of Kailash.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Did Indrajumna Maharaj go there?
Yes, several years ago.
And
said that that is a very brutal journey.
Oh, really? Your Guru Maharaj said that?
Yeah, and also Badharatabu also said that.
Is it not easy?
They're just not easy at all, according to them.然后是讲木的 prayer 吗？这个问题，顶拜咕噜，如果没有遵守四月苦行，仅仅通过遵守五天的 Bhishma Panchaka 就相当于遵守四月苦行了吗？Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. If we missed to follow the Chaturmasi, but if we only follow the last 5 days of Bhishma Panchaka, will that considered as observe the whole Chaturmasi?
Yes, they say like that.
是的，他们是这么说的。
You have to, if you follow the Bhishma Panchaka strictly, it means that on the last Ekadasi of the Chaturmasya, you do Nirjal fasting.
Nirjal fasting. 那也就是说呢，这个如果你要是非常严格的遵守这 Bhishma Panchaka 的话，那就是在 Chaturmasi 的最后一个月。在这个卡提卡月的时候呢，要做这个涅者戒食。
No, not the whole month, just the Ekadasi day, the last Ekadasi.
不是整个这一个月啊，就是在最后一个 Ekadasi 那天就做那种大戒的戒食。
Right, that's five day. That's the fifth day before the end of the Chaturmasya.
那个是在 Chaturmasya 结束的时候，最后五天的最后一天。
So first day you do nirjal, no drinking, no eating.
所以说呢，就那天你要做 nirjal， 就是不喝水，也不吃饭。
And then the next day, the second day, third day, fourth day, fifth day, you have to, you know, there's different levels in which you can do it.
对不起啊，我刚才说错了，不是最后一天，就是在最后五天的第一天这样做，然后在后面的第二天、第三天、第四天的时候呢，就有不同的。就有各种各样不同的那个戒食的规定。
Like the day after Ekadasi, you take some water, and you take、
就是、
you take a little cow urine.
就是在这个艾克达西结束的第二天呢，就稍微喝一点水， 然后呢再喝点牛尿牛尿。
And then the next day, you take a little cow dung.
然后呢再过一天呢就吃一点点牛粪。
And then the next day, you take a little, ghee.
嗯，然后呢再过下面一天呢就吃一点点酥油。
And then the final day, you take some sweet rice.
最后一天呢就吃一点甜奶饭。
And that night, on the evening, on the fifth day, the last day of Ekadasi, that night, you break the fast.
嗯，然后呢，就在这个艾卡达西的最后这一天，就第五天的晚上的时候呢，打破戒食。
But you don't have to do it like that. You can do it, some people like, they will do the fasting on Ekadasi, and then the other days they will just eat fruit and roots.
嗯，但是呢，不一定非得这么做。有些人呢，他可能就是在艾卡达西的那第一天，他会像艾卡达西那样戒食，然后后面的这几天呢，就只是吃一些根茎和一些水果。
So that's also Bhishma Panchaka.
啊，那所以呢，这也是Bhishma Panchaka.
If you didn't follow the Chaturmasa strictly, then you can do the Bhishma Panchaka to make up for it.
对，所以说如果要是没有很严格的去遵循这四月苦行的话呢，那么就通过遵守这五天的 Bhishma Panchaka 来赶上。
yeah. Okay.
然后呢，还有一个问题是来自于北京 Center 的徐小渊的问题。他说的 Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者，刚才 Guru 讲到 Krishna 触碰 Radharani 时。他的脸会绽放光彩，那是什么样的光彩呢？那个光彩是来自于笑容还是脸庞的光呢 ？OK, just now, in your lecture, you mentioned that when Lord Krishna touched Sri Madhurani, Sri Madhurani's face will lightening up. I would like to know what kind of a light, to be showed in her face. Is that kind of light or bright from the complexion itself or from her face, or from her smile?
Yes, from her smile.
是来自于她的笑容。
From her face, from her smile. It's her happiness and seeing Krishna touch her.
Well, 那然后呢是因为她看到 Krishna 会触碰她，所以呢她就会很开心。
嗯，she feels.She can understand Krishna has so much attachment, so much attraction for her.
因为呢，她可以感受到 Sri Krishna 非常的被她所吸引，依恋她。
So it gives her great happiness.
那所以说呢，就会让她很开心。嗯。然后呢，这个 Das 他有问，他问帕尔帕德规定了 Bhishma Panchaka 了吗？This Prabhu asked that.If Srila Prabhupada actually asked us to follow Bhishma Panchaka.
No.
没有。
No, we never heard of it in Srila Prabhupada's time.
嗯，那我们从来就没有在 Srila Prabhupada 的这个时间他在的这个时间内听过他给我们有这样的规定。
But Jayapataka Swami, he follows it, and there are many other sannyasis follow it.
嗯，但是呢 ，Jayapataka Swami 他会遵循。而且还有很多其他的僧伽士们也会这么做。
嗯 ，you know, we didn't know everything on the calendar. The Vaishnava calendar, these things, it's definitely there on the Vaishnava calendar. It says Bhishma Panchak, so Prabhupada didn't introduce it to us, but it's definitely there on the Vaishnava calendar.
嗯，就是在我们的这个 Vaishnava 日历上，其实是有很多的这个信息的。但是呢，舒尔爸爸他并没有就是严格的要求我们需要遵循 Bhishma Pancha， 但是呢，在 Vaishnava 的日历上是有 Bhishma Pancha 这个日子的。
But Prabhupada wanted us to follow the Chaturmasya, and it's in Prabhupada's books.
嗯，但是舒尔爸爸他是希望我们能够遵循 Chaturmasya 四月苦行的，在他的书籍里面是有这样写的。
And if we don't follow, then Prabhupada will be upset.
如果我们要是不遵循的话，说爸爸该不开心了。
And if you, but if you follow the Chaturmasya strictly, you don't need to do Bhishma Panchak.
嗯，但是如果我们要是非常严格的遵循了， Chaturmasya 的话，也就意味着我们就不需要去遵循 Bhishma Pancha 了。
Yeah, the Bhishma Panchaka is only for people who didn't do the Chaturmasya very strictly.
因为这个 Bhishma Panchaka 它只是针对那些没有非常严格的去守这个四月苦行的人来给的一个规定。
And so it's not like it's compulsory for everyone.
那所以说呢，这个 Bhishma Panchaka 它并不是这个对每一个人都是一个必须执行的事儿。
OK。
嗯，然后下面呢是，追随启迪咕噜呢，还是追随帕帕德呢？如果说法不一样 ，So if there were some, you know, gaps, differences in between of the, Diksha Guru and the Srila Prabhupada, who we supposed to follow?For example, like the Bhishma Panchak.
Well, you have to use your intelligence.
首先呢，我们必须要用我们的智慧。
Yeah, if you're following Srila Prabhupada, I said if you're following Srila Prabhupada, then you follow Chaturmasya strictly.
那我刚才已经讲了，如果你要是追随 Srila Prabhupada 的教导的话呢，那你就非常严格的去遵循四月苦行。
Then you don't need to do Bhishma Panchak.
那这样的话，你就不需要去做这个 Bhishma Panchak 了。
But Bhishma Panchak is not against Prabhupada's teachings. It's there on the calendar.
但是呢，就即便是追随 Bhishma Panchak 的话呢，也不会就说就违反了Srila Prabhupada的这个教导了，因为 Bhishma Panchak 它的确是在 Vaishnava 日历上有的。
So you can suit yourself. You can decide for yourself.
所以说呢，你可以自己去决定一下。And Achintya Veda Maji asked, 第一个苦行月只戒菠菜吗？ Well, because the first month is to fast from the green leaves. So she's asking if only for spinach, not any other greens.
Well,It seems to vary. It's never been, you know, some people, they will just follow, they will only not take spinach, and other people, they will stop all green leafy vegetables.
那有的其实这个还是有不同的说法的。就有些人呢，他可能他只不吃菠菜，还有些人呢，他是彻底的什么绿叶菜都不吃了。
So it's not, I don't know, exactly what is required. It's difficult.
其实对于我来说，我也很难知道，就是到底它这个具体是怎么个算法。
In some places it says, some places it will say green leafy vegetables, in other places it will say spinach.
因为有的地方就会说是绿叶菜，还有的地方呢就直接说的是菠菜。
So it seems to be flexible. It seems to be, there seems to be some variation there.
那所以呢，看起来好像还是有一些灵活度在这儿呢，有各种的这个说法。Because China has all kinds of green leaves vegetables. Probably
yeah.
India only have spinach.
Mm-hmm. Well, we have also, what to say, I don't know the answer really to that question.
阿马尔说呢，就对您这个问题呢，他的确不知道该怎么回答了。
You can ask your own spiritual master what standard he wants you to follow.
要不然这个问题其实您可以问一下您自己的灵性导师，看一下他希望您去追随怎么样一个标准。Marge, all of the questions you have answered.
They're all finished, huh?
Yes, all finished.
Oh, wonderful. So, okay, so we will stop here today.
Okay. Thank you, Marge.
I have to thank you so much. Thank you very, very much, Dhanakili Mataji, for your tolerance and your kindness and patience for doing all this. Okay. So, are you coming tomorrow again or not?
Yes, tomorrow morning.
Oh, three in a row, eh? Wow.
Yeah. The reason is because Guru Mani Maji has other service this evening, so she cannot do this afternoon.
Oh, okay. Okay, so thank you so much, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, Marj, thank you so much.
Okay, so Srila Prabhupada ki.
Hi.
Go back to Vrinda ki.
Recording stopped.